so she you dey why me me ti ba so be kere so fa so fa lo o ye ko so be like like taking it further. Are you ready? Yeah. Are you ready?
Jojo.
Oba wa lo jebe say eni ti o ni je ndupe se.
Eni ti o ni je ndupe.
Yeah. Have you believed, Thomas, because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and yet believed. Alleluia. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. This is the day which the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Alleluia. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Alleluia. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory be to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, Hear, O Israel, the Lord your God is one Lord. And you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind and with all your strength. This is the first commandment, and the second is like, namely this, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. There's no other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Lord, have mercy upon us and write all these your laws in our hearts. Hear the words of comfort. Our Savior Christ says to all who truly turn to him, Come to me, all who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Hear what St. Paul says. The saying is true and worthy of full acceptance that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John says. If anyone sins, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace with all people, meekly kneeling upon our knees. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbors in thought and word and deed. Through negligence, through weakness, through undeliberate fault, we have not sufficiently walked according to the mind of Christ. We have named the name of Christ, but have not departed from iniquity. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. The collect and the ministry of the word. Almighty Father, who in your great mercy made glad the disciples with the sight of the risen Lord, give us such knowledge of his presence with us, that we may be strengthened and sustained by his risen life, and serve you continually in righteousness and truth, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, ever one God, world without end. Amen.
The Old Testament reading is taken from the book of Exodus, chapter 15, from verses 1 through 11. Exodus chapter 15, from verses 1 through 11. Then Moses and the children of Israel sang this song to the Lord and spoke, saying, I will sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. The horse and its rider he has thrown into the sea. The Lord is my strength and my song, and he has become my salvation. He is my God, and I will praise him, my father's God, and I will exalt him. The Lord is a man of war. The Lord is his name. Pharaoh's chariots and his army he has cast into the sea. His chosen captains also are drowned in the Red Sea. The depths have covered them. They sank to the bottom like a stone. Your right hand, O Lord, has become glorious in power. Your right hand, O Lord, has dashed the enemy in pieces. And in the greatness of your excellence, you have overthrown those who rose up against you. You sent forth your wrath. It consumed them like stubble. And with the blast of your nostrils, the waters were gathered together. The floods stood upright like a heap. The depths congealed in the heart of the sea. The enemy said, I will pursue, I will overtake, I will divide the spoil. My desire shall be satisfied on them. I will draw my sword, my hand shall destroy them. But you blew with your wind, the sea covered them. They sank like lead in the mighty waters. Who is like you, O Lord, among the gods? Who is like you, glorious in holiness, fearful in praises, doing wonders? This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The epistle is written in the first letter of Peter, chapter 1, beginning at the third verse. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who according to the abundant mercy has begotten us again to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. To an inheritance incorruptible and undefiled, and that does not fade away, reserved in heaven for you, who are kept by the power of God through faith for salvation, ready to be revealed in the last time. In these you greatly rejoice, though now for a little while, if need be, you have been grieved by various trials, that the genuineness of your faith, being much more precious than gold that perishes, though it is tested by fire, may be found to praise, honor, and glory at the revelation of Jesus Christ, whom having not seen you love, though now you do not see him, yet believing, you rejoice with joy inexpressible and full of glory, receiving the end of your faith, the salvation of your soul. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Oh, The Holy Gospel is written in the 24th chapter of the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ as recorded by St. Luke, commencing the reading at the first verse. First day of the week, very early in the morning, they came unto the sepulchre, bringing the spices which they had prepared, and certain hoarders with them. And they found the stone rolled away from the sepulchre. And they entered in and found not the body of the Lord Jesus. And it came to pass, as they were much perplexed thereabout, behold, two men stood by them in shining garments. And as they were afraid and bowed down their faces to the earth, they said unto them, Why seek ye the living among the dead? He is not here, but he is risen. Remember how he spake unto you when he was yet in Galilee, saying, The Son of Man must be delivered unto the hands of sinful men and be crucified, and the third day rise again. And they remember his words and returned from the sepulchre and told all these things unto the 11 and to all the rest. It was Mary Magdalene and Joanna and Mary the mother of James and other women that were with them which told these things unto the apostles. And their word seems to them as idle tales, and they believed them not. Then arose Peter and ran unto the sepulchre, and stood him down. He beheld the linen clothes laid by themselves, and departed, wondering in himself at that which had come to pass. This is the gospel of Christ.
Our Heavenly Father, we thank you. We give you praise and glory for this hour. We ask, O God, that your word in my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts, O God, will be acceptable unto you. In Jesus Christ's mighty name we pray. Amen. Please sit. I want to specially thank the Lord Almighty for this opportunity that he has given unto me to stand before his people. And I also want to thank the vicar and all the clergy for the way they have accepted us and the way they have been treating us. I want to thank the entire church for the way we have expressed God's love to us. We have actually seeing that the love of God in this place is in this place, and I believe that God will continue to keep us all in Jesus' name. As we continue to forge ahead in our Christian life, the Lord will continue to build us up in the name of Jesus. Thank you very much. The thing before us this morning is the Christian living hope. The Christian living hope. And I know it is generally said that when there is life, there is what? When there is life, there is what? There is hope. But we all agree that that statement might not be completely true. That's why sometimes you see people that had life deciding to take their own life because they became hopeless. Because it seems as if there was no other way to go. But we know that Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. So when we are saying when there is life, there is hope, we could actually refer to Christians that have Jesus, who is the life in them. So when you have the life of Jesus in you, then you truly have hope. So when there is life, there is hope. That should actually refer to us as Christians. We know that because we have Jesus, there's no trouble in this world that will be able to overcome Jesus. He overcame. And so we are sure that we too will overcome. From the Old Testament reading, we see the Lord coming to the Israelites, saving them. So they had a song of victory. How the Lord helped them to overcome the Egyptians. How the Lord drowned the Egyptians in the Red Sea, the same sea that the Israelites walked through on dry land. So we know that Jesus gives us salvation. He delivers us from every harm and danger. That same God is alive today. Then from the epistle, we know that Jesus died and he rose again. We know that many other religious group, we know the tomb or the burial ground of their founders. Some of them, their bones are still there. Some of them, their bones have even decayed. But Jesus died and he rose again. The living hope of a Christian. It is because he died. He's no more in the grave. 2 days after, on the third day, the Bible says he rose again from the dead. So he's no longer there. And that's why I like the Anglican Church, who will believe in the cross. We know that Jesus is no more on the cross. He was moved from the cross to the grave. From the grave, he arose. That is the victory. That is the hope of every Christian. So we say Christianity is not just a religion. Religion is people trying to seek God. We all believe in the existence of a supreme being. That's the definition of a religion. So we know that Christianity, in some sense, is also a religion, but it's beyond every other kind of religion. People trying to seek God, but in Christianity, we see God seeking man. He came to seek and to save that which was lost. So we are privileged to have God coming for us, not just we struggling to get to him. He has made a way for us. So God is reaching out to us. All he expects for us is just for us to lift our hands and let him have it, and let him have his way. So the Israelites were delivered from the Egyptians who were troubling them. So I want to look at the epistle again together. First Peter chapter 1, verse 3. Says, blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who according to his abundant mercies hath begotten us again unto a lively hope for the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance incorruptible and undefiled, that fadeth not away, reserved in heaven for you. Amen. There's an inheritance that is reserved in heaven for us. So God continued in his salvation. By his mercies, he had begotten us in Christ Jesus unto a lively hope by the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ from the dead. So we have hope. We have a living hope. Because I know that sometimes, whether doctor or maybe your auto mechanic that works on your cars, sometimes they look at you and say, okay, let's hope that this thing will serve for some time. And then you to go back and feel, oh yes, I know that this thing will not last, but let's just manage it. There's a temporal hope in that kind of situation. Sometimes doctors look at you and feel, oh, this sickness, I will just hope that it will last for, maybe you can still be alive for another 2 months when we hear such reports from the doctors, or 2 years. Some of us, before that time, would have given up because you feel it's a hopeless situation. Those hopes that we get sometimes can only be temporary. But the Lord Jesus Christ has given us a living hope. By his death and resurrection, we know that even death is not the end of a Christian's existence. We could just cross from one part of eternity to the other. So we have this hope in Christ Jesus because he died and he rose again. And then the kind of inheritance that is awaiting us in heaven, Bible says, the inheritance we have is incorruptible. I know that some of us, maybe our parents were well-to-do and were able to leave us with very good inheritance, and then you get into it, but you discover that these things will fade away. Sometimes I know there was, back then in my village, there was this very, very beautiful house when we were in primary school. You just run down and just to look, have a glimpse at this house. But 35 years down the line, it's almost like one of the oldest structure you can see. It's fading away. Bible says everything we see, they are temporal. They will all fade away. But the only thing that cannot fade is the Lord Jesus Christ. It's the fact that he's no longer in the grave. He died and he rose again. So we have an inheritance that cannot be corrupted. It's incorruptible, as we see in verse 4 of that 1 Peter chapter 1. And it's undefiled. Who is it for? It's reserved for us all in heaven. So our prayer and our desire and our aim should be that we will be able to make it on that last day. That his death and resurrection will never be in vain in our lives in Jesus' name. So our hope as Christians is a living one, which means there's no ending. I love that song that said, with love that knows no ending. Our hope knows no ending. He will give us the good things of life. No matter what we are going through, after this life, we know there's another and a better life that awaits us. So we should learn to keep on trusting him. Sometimes, sometimes devil wants to bring our way that, are you really sure of this resurrection? If we look at the book of Acts, chapter 1, from verse 1 to 3, Acts 1:1-3, there said these things that I've written unto you, Timothy, that you may know that the things that Jesus both began to do and to teach. And verse 3 says that he showed himself unto them, as unto the disciples, with many infallible proof that he's alive, appearing unto them for 40 days. So Jesus showed himself with many infallible proofs. So today, even the whole history, everybody in this world, we know the date is either BC or AD, either before Christ or after the death of Jesus Christ. So everyone in history knows that Jesus came. And the question is, who is this Jesus that the whole world could talk about him? Easter, wonderful celebration. He's the only one that died and rose again. This Jesus is our hope. So we must continue in him because it is evident, it is so clear that he, even Muslims believe in it. And I know I was having interaction with him. I said, hey, we know that he rose again from the dead because God just raised him from the dead. I said, beautiful. If you believe in that, you should also believe that this same Jesus, as we're told in Acts chapter 1, verse 11, was taken up from you into heaven, will come in the same way as you see him go into heaven. So why not come to Jesus today? Because he has a better place arranged for us. The book of John, chapter 14, Jesus said that he was going away from the disciples. And that when he goes away, that he is going to prepare a place for us. And that where he is, there we will be also. So sometimes when there's this other set that will argue that no, we are not going, nobody is going to heaven, only 144,000 is going to heaven from the tribe of Israel. And sometimes those days I will want to argue. It's okay, just read the Bible then, because the Bible mentioned that there are multitudes that no one could number that will also be part of this. But I'm like, okay, if you say that with this John chapter 14, verse 3, it makes it clear to me. Jesus said, where he is, there I will be also. So I'm relaxed. Whether I decide to be stay in heaven or come to the new heaven or new earth, I'm also okay, we are inheriting the earth. But where Jesus is, there I will be also. That's my greatest joy. That's my greatest hope. That no matter what happens to me, we know of some places where Christians are being persecuted. Some just, okay, like Sundays like this, we know we are going to church. We are not even sure whether we will come back alive. Some of them will not really go back alive because some of them are being killed. But that they only kill the flesh. Our soul will be with the Lord. Where Jesus is, there I will be also. That is his promise for me. That is his promise for you. So I want you to lay hold on to that. That there is a hope, no matter what we go through. And that this hope also is in our daily living. He had told us in Hebrews chapter 11, verse 5b, that he will never leave us nor forsake us. So that's another joy. That even though I am alive now, even though I am going through stuff, there are some stuff that many of us are going through, that sometimes Sundays might just try to cover it up. But deep within, we know the troubles we are going through. We know the pains. There are some that are in serious pain, emotionally, physically, socially, financially. But Jesus has promised us that he will never leave us nor forsake us. So that hope gives us keeps us going. And he also said in Acts chapter 10, verse 33, that how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth, that he went about doing good, healing all those that were sick. So the hope of good health is also in Jesus. He says his wish above all things is that we prosper and be in health, even as our soul prospers. So there is healing in the name of Jesus. So if you are here, I want you to believe God. Have that strong hope, that strong faith, that strong belief that is able to heal you. And you'll be healed in Jesus' name. No matter what brought about the sickness, sometimes we may have erred. And then, as Jesus told the man, say, your sins are forgiven thee. And his sins were forgiven and he was healed. So if you come to Jesus today, if the sickness is as a result of one ear head to the other, know that once you confess your sin, he forgives you and heals you. The other one was, the disciple asked, whose sin is this? He said, no, that the name of God might be glorified. The name of the Lord will be glorified in your life in Jesus' name. And then the final, as I conclude, in Revelation chapter 1, verse 7, Jesus said, behold, the word said, behold, he comes with the clouds, and that all eyes will see him, and those that pierce him. And there will be a lot of wailing. Jesus is going to come again, and he's coming with a cloud. He's not coming as a lamb that was born as a lamb anymore, or as a child that was born in a stable placed in a manger. He's coming as a conquering king, and he's coming to reign. So this is our hope. He will come for the church, and he will come again in his power and glory. And I pray that the Lord will continue to help us to live lives of the living hope that will make known his eternity to others and to us, and to live lives to the glory of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit.
The Lord be with you. As we remain standing, please let us affirm our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit he became incarnate of the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son who is worshipped and glorified, he has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. These three abide: faith, hope, and love. Well, the greatest of these is love. So Lord, renew our faith and increase it. Sustain our hope in you. And let us be clothed above all in your love that keeps faith and hope aflame and sustains our life in you. Grant us grace for the living of these days. Let us pray for the church and for the world, and let us thank God for his goodness. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, you promised through your Son, Jesus Christ, to hear us when we pray in faith. Strengthen Henry, our primate, Akinpelu, our bishop, and all your church in the service of Christ, that those who confess your name may be united in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory in the world. Even as we pray for the Right Reverend Martin Minns, the retired founding Bishop of Kenna, who is 80 years old today, and ask God for good health and divine sustenance for him in old age and the rest of his days. Let's continue to see the Anglican Communion thrive, and the church alive and well. And as you pray, for the Right Reverend S.A.Z., his family, clergy, and people of Enugu North Diocese, as indeed as God has promised, the gates of hell never prevail against this church worldwide, wherever it is situated. And in this diocese of Lagos mainland, we pray for the Venerable Dr. Francis Falako and his family and ministry. As the church, we all may be indeed the light of the world, reflecting Christ, the light of the world and the salt of the earth. A city on a hill that cannot be hidden. Lord, in thy mercy, hear our prayer. Bless and guide our rulers, give wisdom to all in authority, and direct us in every nation in the ways of justice and of peace, that people may honor one another and seek the common good. As you continue to cause a recession of all that is unholy, unjust, unfair, unkind, untrue, false, a recession of all evil, and a progression of all that is just, holy, fair, true, wonderful, beautiful, all that is of you in our land and in our time. Lord, in thy mercy, hear our prayer. Give grace to us, our families and friends, and to all our neighbors, that we may serve Christ in one another and love as he loves us. Even as we pray also for the following businesses this week, that God will increase and enlarge these businesses and keep them standing in him, growing from glory to glory, increasing from height to height and strength to strength. Alec Associates, Customized Building Services Limited, Multi-Plan Development Linkages, that it may be well with them in every way. And as we pray for all those who have birthdays this week, and who celebrate landmarks in whatever shape or form, especially using those who celebrate their birthdays today as a point of contact. Simisola Idowu Onyikonsola, Oreoluwa Oluwatosin Shoga, Simisola Onyikonsola Odebi. And all of those who celebrate birthdays today and throughout the rest of this week, as is the day, so may their strength be. Open heavens over them. Their feet is iron, their shoes as brass. They may thrive more and more and be well sustained and live in hope until the end. Lord, in thy mercy, hear our prayer. Comfort and heal all those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit, especially those who'd like to be here but cannot on account of ill health or infirmity, those sick at home, as well as those in admission and hospital, as well as all those in charge of their care, the doctors, nurses, paramedics, their relations. Give them courage and hope in their troubles, and bring them the joy of your salvation. Lord, in thy mercy, hear prayers. Hear us as we remember those who have died in the faith of Christ, particularly those who remember by name in faith in the silence of our hearts. According to your promises, grant us with them a share in your eternal kingdom. Lord, in thy mercy, hear our prayer. Rejoicing in the fellowship of all your saints, we commend ourselves and all Christian people to your unfailing love. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. The Lord be with you. Please rise for the peace. Christ is our peace. He has reconciled us to God in one body by the cross. We meet in his name and share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you and also with you. Let us offer one another a sign of peace. We have this bread to offer, which the earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Amen. Yours, Lord, is the greatness, the power, the glory, the splendor, and the majesty, for everything in heaven and on earth is yours. All things come from you, and of your own do we give you. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right. It is our duty and joy at all times and in all places to give you thanks and praise, Holy Father, Heavenly King, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ, your only Son, our Lord. For he is your living Word. Through him you have created all things from the beginning and formed us in your own image. Through him you have freed us from the slavery of sin, giving him to be born as man and to die upon the cross. You raised him from the dead and exalted him to your right hand on high. Through him you have sent upon us your holy and life-giving Spirit and made us a people for your own possession. And now we give you thanks, because through him you have given us the hope of a glorious resurrection, so that although death comes to us all, yet we rejoice in the promise of eternal life. For to your faithful people life is changed, not taken away. And when our mortal flesh is laid aside, an everlasting dwelling place is made ready for us in heaven. Therefore, with angels and archangels and all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Accept our praises, Heavenly Father, through your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. And as we follow his example and obey his command, grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us his body and blood. Who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread and gave you thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Therefore, Heavenly Father, we remember his offering of himself made once for all upon the cross, and proclaim his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension. As we look for his coming in glory, we celebrate with this bread and this cup his one perfect sacrifice. Accept through him, our great high priest, this our sacrifice of thanks and praise. And as we eat and drink these holy gifts in the presence of your divine majesty, renew us by your Spirit, inspire us with your love, and unite us in the body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, and with him, and in him, by the power of the Holy Spirit, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honor and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. We do not presume to come to your table, merciful Lord, trusting in our unrighteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under your table, but you are the same Lord whose nature is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that we may evermore dwell in him and he in us. Amen. Draw near with faith. Receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave you, and his blood, which he shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that he died for you, and feed on him in your heart by faith with thanksgiving. The body of Christ, keep you in eternal life. The blood of Christ, keep you in eternal life.
Thank you. Please let us stand with our kingdom seed. As we all know, this is a scheme in this diocese for the funders of God's kingdom and to spread the gospel. Please let us stand and put our kingdom seed in our envelope as we pray. Father, we bless your name because you are the giver of every good and perfect gift. We thank you, Father Lord, for the privilege given to us today to partner with you. We have come today with our kingdom seed. Lord, as we sow the seed of faith today, Lord, I pray, may your kingdom be enlarged in the name of Jesus. Lord, I pray in this diocese, your light will shine, the world will see, and they glorify your name in the name of Jesus. Lord, I pray through us, your name will be known throughout the world in the name of Jesus. Accept, O Lord, this gift we here bring before you. And I pray, may we be rewarded accordingly. Thank you, Lord, because you have done it. For we have prayed in Jesus' name.
Jesus came and stood among his disciples and said to them, "Peace be with you." Alleluia. And as he taught us, so we pray as we kneel, "Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. People of God, it's now time once again to come forward with rejoicing and thanksgiving, a heart of gratitude, a song on our lips, a dance in our step, as the band strikes up the chord and the Guild of Stewards brings the offering bag to the front. Let us come with our Sunday collection, welfare offering, and scholarship fund.
To say thank you for the gift of life and for the privilege we have even to worship in your sanctuary, to call on your name and for the hope that we have in Christ Jesus. Lord, we say receive our hearty thanks in Jesus' name. And as we continue in the journey of this week, Lord, we ask, Lord, your presence will continue to remain with us in the name of Jesus. May you continue to hold our steps and grant unto us favor like never before in the name of Jesus. We pray, O God, that as many hearts as troubled, dear O God, Father, you will restore a new hope in them in the name of Jesus. that, O God, the resurrection of Christ Jesus will be evident in all that concerns us and our homes in the name of Jesus. Accept our offerings, O God, and use to the glory of your name. And through this, let your blessings be multiplied in our lives. Thank you, mighty Jesus, for we have prayed in Jesus' name.
Bring ye all the tithes into my storehouse. In fulfillment of that instruction, please let us come forward, dancing, rejoicing to the altar with our tithes, project card, maintenance card, and women's sacrifice card as the band once again strikes up the chord.
Your tithes to God this Sunday, and I want you to just talk to God again, the God who hears our prayers, the God who does great and mighty things, the one that has said is him that giveth us the ability to make wealth. Let's pray, especially all who have transferred their tithe. I want you to also just connect and pray and say, Lord, our God and our Father, accept for this offering with joy and gladness from my hands. Rebuke the devourer. And Lord, bless me in such a way that there will not be enough room to contain it. Our God and our Father, once again, we give you thanks for us, oh God, the privilege we have to bring our tithe, our project card, a maintenance card offering, the women's sacrifice card. The Lord, you will accept, oh God, this offering with joy and gladness from our hands. And we look up unto you, him, oh Lord, who blesses all that we have brought forth to his house. The Lord, you will accept and bless these your children in the name of Jesus. Once again, upon this your altar, we pray. The Lord, you will rebuke the devourer for our sake in the name of Jesus. And we pray, our God and our Father, that you will pour down your blessings. You will open the windows of heaven and pour your blessings upon us in the name of Jesus. May the Lord accept your offering. May his blessings be permanent in your life. I sanctify you and your offerings in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Given for all blessings in every dimension, please let us come dancing with the heart of thanksgiving as the Guild of Stewards brings the offering back to the front and the bank strikes up the chord.
For all your protection, for the joy of celebrations of birthday, wedding, anniversary, promotional offering, journey, mercy, good and glorious things that you continue to do in our lives, oh Lord, we worship you, we acknowledge you, we adore you, we say thank you, Lord, for everything. Be thou glorified in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray for as many that celebrated their joy of birthdays, that, Lord, you will add more years to their lives in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray for every home that are celebrating their wedding anniversary, oh Lord. These marriages will continue to be intact in the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord will continue to bless you in your going out and your coming in. He will continue to accept your offering of thanksgiving in the name of Jesus Christ. And things of celebrations will never cease in our homes. Thank you, oh Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.
Easter Thanksgiving, others, if you were not here last week, Easter Sunday, now is your opportunity to come with a heart full of Easter, and may this Easter be forever as we come forward with rejoicing and thanksgiving, thanking God for his ultimate sacrifice on our behalf. Band.
Oh, sure.
Heavenly Father, Lord, to you we return all thanks for the great love that you have shown to us, for that powerful sacrifice that you have made on our behalf. We thank you, Lord, for your children who are here celebrating the victory of our Lord Jesus Christ over sin and death. I pray and I declare into their life that the power of resurrection will bring you greater joy in the name of Jesus. I pray God Almighty will grant you overwhelming victory in the name of Jesus. I pray his presence will not cease in your mouth in the name of Jesus. And I pray that the joy of the Lord will continually be your portion in the name of Jesus. May the Lord accept you and your offering. May the Lord sanctify you. May the Lord make your way straight in the name of Jesus. And may the Lord Almighty grant all your heart desire. Thank you, Father Lord, because you know you have done it for us. For we are prayed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Oba torun juba Oba sere o sere Oba ti mo yo ninu re Oba saye juba Oba torun juba Oba sere o sere Oba ti mo yo ninu re
The Lord be with you. We have a wedding Thanksgiving in the house. A brother, one of us, is a former, I think, president of Yaba Tech Fellowship, and he has been with us, a beloved brother and his amiable wife, Mr. and Mrs. Udede Genesis. He's also a member of our choir. Has been with us since his days in Yaba Tech. So it's nice to see you and your wife in church. So they will dance to the altar as we all support them as they come to the altar for Thanksgiving, wedding Thanksgiving.
Okay.
Our God and our Father, we can't thank you enough for the life of this couple, Lord, who kneel before you. We thank you, Lord, in your diverse ways. You have shown yourself faithful in their life. You have shown that you are the God of provision. You are the God of multiplication. And today we loud your name and we thank you because, Lord, you were the one who has backed up your son and your daughter and has made, oh God, their wedding ceremony a success. We thank you, Lord, oh God, for Donny Messes from Lagos, oh God, to Shaki, and you brought them back. Lord, we say, may your name be forever praised in the name of Jesus. Lord, as they start their wedlock journey, we pray, our God and our Father, that your favor will go with them. We declare and prophesy into your life that the Lord will never leave you. The Lord will stand by you. The Lord will be your rock. The Lord will be your pillar in the name of Jesus. We pray that the Lord will make you friends of each other. The Lord will increase you and multiply you on all sides in the name of Jesus. Generations will call you blessed. The favor of the Lord will go with you. Whatever you lay your hands upon will prosper in the name of Jesus. Your word has said, he that finds a wife, findeth a good thing and obtain favor from the Lord. Lord, as a church today, as we rejoice, oh God, with Mr. and Mrs. today, Genesis, we pray that the favor of God will go with both of you in the name of Jesus. You will be fruitful. You will multiply. You will subdue the earth in the name of Jesus. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you. May the Lord lift up the light of his light of his countenance upon you. May he grant you peace. May he grant you joy. May he favor you on all sides, now and forevermore.
Mothers Union members to please march forward as we welcome one of our own into the Mothers Union. Your marriage shall be a blessing.
Good children surround your table. You will see your children's children. So says the Lord of
all. Hallelujah.
Your marriage shall be a blessing. Good children surround your table.
We thank God for a new day and a new bride. We thank God for Mr. Genesis for bringing this beautiful lady. God will continue to bless your marriage. You are welcome to BAM Church. This is your church. And you are also a member of Mothers Union. So we are presenting something beautiful from...
On behalf of everyone, every Mothers Union member of our church, Bishop Adelakun Owe's Memorial Church, we present this gift to you, and we have prayed for you and your husband. We have prayed for you today that your marriage shall be a blessing in the name of Jesus. You continue to experience God's favor in your marriage, good children, beautiful children, in the name of Jesus. God Almighty, we continue to move you forward. It will continue to guide your steps in the mighty name of Jesus. The enemy will not come in between you in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen.
Congratulations. You're welcome. Your marriage shall be
a blessing. Good children surround your table. You will see your children. So says the Lord.
Monthly Thanksgiving for this month of April, this Easter month. All the women, please, as the band strikes up the chord again.
Praise the Lord, oh my soul.
Father, we thank you. We thank you for your daughters that have come before you in this month of April for their monthly women thanksgiving. Lord, we thank you for how you have been with them. Lord, may your name be exalted forever in Jesus' name. Amen. We thank you, God, for the joys of being a woman. Lord, we thank you for how you've made them, oh God, virtuous women, oh God. We pray, God, that you continue to keep them, oh God, in the name of Jesus. You will keep them in their homes. Lord, you will keep them in their workplaces. Lord, you will keep them wherever they may go, Lord, in Jesus' name. Lord, that you will bless them even in this month. Lord, come next month, oh God, they shall come with greater rejoicing in the name of Jesus. Lord, concerning their husbands, Lord, you will bless. Concerning their children, oh God, you will bless. Lord, concerning their grandchildren, Lord, you will bless. Lord, all that are connected or related to them, Lord, you will continue to bless. Lord, they will never hear bad news, oh God, concerning any of them in the name of Jesus. Lord, you will keep them alive. Lord God Almighty, that come next month, oh God, they will all be alive to rejoice once more in your presence in Jesus' name. Lord, beyond all that, oh God, that you continue to keep them in you. That the enemy will not be able to snatch any of these ones from you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Thank you because, Lord, their lives, oh God, they are hidden in Christ, in God. And nobody will be able to touch them. Thank you, Father, for answering all our prayers. In Jesus Christ's mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
Da, 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 da.
as if the band just woke up. Okay. Happy Sunday to you all. Once again, in Christ's name, I say welcome. Can you help me welcome the person beside you and say it's nice to see you in church? Can you help me pray for the person that the week ahead of you will be great, will be glorious, will be an amazing week for you in the name of Jesus. Is there anyone worshiping with us for the first time? Is there anyone? Can you just wave? Anyone, is your first time? Is there anyone? Okay, once again, I say happy Sunday to you. Hallelujah, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, Christ is risen.
He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
And I pray that as we celebrate the risen Christ and we look forward to his ascension and also Pentecost, I pray that that joy will be with us in the name of Jesus. Once again, let me appreciate every one of you for your gift to us, the clergy, this Easter season. And I sincerely want to thank, you know, a lot of people sent me messages. It was a very busy day for me on Friday. Thank you for your love. In fact, thank you for your gift. Some people's gift is even oppressing me as the vicar. The gift was so oppressive. I want to thank you. Can you help me say to the person beside you, you are too much? I deeply appreciate you. God will continue to bless all of you. As the Yobas will say, Unkwanyo, La Mama Barawa, Mashiluruko Jesu. It will be things of joy that we'll be celebrating with one another in the name of Jesus. Let me not forget all those born in April, wedded in April, promoted in April. So let's not forget that our community hymn singing comes up last Sunday. I think it's 30th of April. And I think it will be a time for us to reaffirm and rejoice in the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. I hope the choir, I hope you are ready for us. I hope you are ready for us. Okay, God, we're going to bless you in the name of Jesus. Also, let me continue to appreciate all our women as you continue to give and support the women work, especially as we plan for our Diocesan Women Conference come 27th to 29th of July. I want to thank you. It's all a time of preparation for us. And we pray that God will continue to bless you. So gradually, as we move closer, all our fathers, our brothers, will also have to contact you as you support our women. It will be a huge success in the name of Jesus. Those in council, don't forget today, after the 10 a.m. service, we have a meeting. And all the committee chairmen, please continue to lift them up in prayers and pray that God will use them to the praise and glory of his name. Confirmation class, if you have not been confirmed, you don't even understand what it means, or you have been baptized and you want to come for the Lord's Supper as we do in this service, there is always a preparation, a class where we do a lot of teachings. That is what is called the confirmation class. So please see Reverend Ayobami Akinade and pick your form. God bless you. Celebration of Jesus, let's not forget, is a time of fellowship and ministering every Tuesday, 9 a.m. Join us. I know the others' fellowship is this week, this Tuesday. Join us at 11 a.m. Let's not forget, the midweek communion also comes up every Wednesday at 6 p.m. Midday prayer, we're here every noon to study God's word and to pray. So please join us. Let's take a look at other notices in a bulletin. And let us remember the Adigun family in a prayer. And as we go this week, it will be an awesome week for me and you in the name of Jesus. One thing I must not forget, this week is our vigil. Let me say to the person beside you, this Friday is our vigil. I hope the person is smiling. So encourage, please. We want you to be there. Let's pray together. The Lord will bless you all in Jesus' name. The Lord be with you. Let us pray.
The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ, amen.